My entire childhood was spent down at this cricket club, whether I was playing, whether I was watching my brother play, helping my mum do the tees.
This is LV's take with Kate and David.
This morning.
I honestly don't know what people do who don't have cricket in their lives.
I've always believed with young people that if you try to force something on them, that it doesn't work. I just brought them down here. Kate just naturally came, wanted to play, wanted to pick a ball up. Kate was quite clearly a natural bowler. Bobby, our son, said that to me. He said, I took Kate down to the cricket club and she can bowl. I said, what do you mean? She underarm? He said, no, she can bowl.
My brother's not here to defend himself, so I can tell this story. Bobby was the first team captain for about 10 years here, and I think he politically thought that it probably wouldn't be acceptable to pick his little sister in the team. So I never played when he was captain. And then he stepped down and another lad came in as captain, a lad called Danny, and he picked me within one of his first 2 years of captaincy. And at this point, I'd made my test debut, my international ODI debut and my T20 debut. So the only debut I hadn't really made was playing for Heywood. And I felt a lot of pressure. And I remember thinking I was more nervous for my Heywood debut than I was for my international debut, which is crazy. It was a really, really nice moment for myself and my brother because I got to play in the same team as him for the first time. Looking back, it all feels like it was a day like this with blue sky and sunshine. But I think from when I actually started playing cricket, it really shapes you as a person who you spend your time with. And I think specifically when I got into the boys team, it could quite easily have knocked my confidence if they didn't accept me as a cricket player. I don't think I would probably have had the career that I've had without that first group of lads that I met down here on that Tuesday night at training.
Shouts of catch, opportunity for cross. Is this the wicket England need? Taken, really well judged.
It's been one of the main talking points in women's sport now for probably about 5 years. And I don't think anyone could predict how much women's cricket would grow. And now young girls who might be seven at their cricket clubs learning how to play the game have female role models, which I never had when I was a kid.
The thing for me was when I left school and was asked to be a professional footballer, I just thought that they would soon find out that wasn't good enough. But gradually I learnt the game. I learnt how to be what I became. And I think that's something that Kate's done as well. And she's learned how to be a professional cricketer.
I remember when I first told mum and dad that I got my professional contract. And just before I signed it, dad rang me and he said, you need to be aware that this isn't going to be easy. He said, if it was easy, then everyone would be professional sports people. One of the things that my uncle Bob taught me when I was a seven-year-old was A, how to hold the ball. So I'm a seam bowler, and for a seam bowler you want the seam to be as upright as possible. So you put your fingers behind the ball like this. And the next thing he taught me is that everything should be in straight lines. Keep it simple. The simpler you keep it, the better. And he always told me that from the very back of your run-up to when you've delivered the ball, you want everything to be in a nice straight line so it's going towards the target, which is the stumps, which is what I'm trying to hit every time I bowl.
Club like ours, I wouldn't be able to exist if there wasn't sponsorships of some kind. So the funds for runs from LV is really invaluable.
You just want kids to be coming down to their cricket clubs and having the opportunity to play. And without money, you can't keep places like this going. The next Heather Knight, the next Tammy Beaumont, it might, you know, create the next generation of players who go on to play for England.